Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello, this is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you Matters of Faith with Graphic Online. Living Streams, we meet at the Life Cathedral behind the Treat Fair, behind Zenith College. And we meet on Sundays in the morning, 7 to 9, and then 10 to 12 for two services. For our midweek services on Wednesdays, we meet at the Life Cathedral, same place, but this time, 6:30 in the evening to 8 p.m. in the evening. Now, back to my thoughts, it's approaching elections and everybody now sees what's going on. And sometimes election week or election year brings unrest and all sorts of disquiet within citizenry. And sometimes these electoral brouhaha becomes very dangerous because people get killed and people's lives are taken to the cleaners and disposed of as waste. And for me, that is a very, very big problem. But the Bible has thoughts on all these things. And one of the things that I'm going to speak today is live and die by the sword. Live and die by the sword. That means have life or death by the sword. In 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 32 to 33, 1 Samuel chapter 15, 32 to 33. There is a powerful story there. You know, one time God came to town and God said to Saul the king through Samuel that I remember the sins of Amalek, the Amalekites, and what they did to Israel when Israel was coming to the promised land. He said, I remember the things they did. And listen, I'm going to hold them to it. And so God told Samuel, tell Saul to wipe away everybody, everything. Even if a roach is on the wall, wipe it away. I said, wow. I mean, this is God saying, I don't want, the memory of them must be blotted out. There should be no reminder that a city like that place ever was in existence. That is God. But one way or the other, when Saul went to the battle, he spared Agag, the king, and the best of the sheep and the fatling of the cows. He spared those ones. And then, I mean, in disobedience to what God said, then someone comes to town to ask him, what has happened to you? What did you do? He even lied. He said, it's the people. And then someone said, okay, because of this, that, the kingdom has been taken away from you. So Saul's period or era as king was over. In fact, he had an expiry date at his back. He just didn't know. But after Samuel had reprimanded King Saul, rebuked him to the core of his bones, the Bible said, he said, where is Agag the Amalekite? Where is Agag the Amalekite? And then they brought Agag in. And look at what he said. When he came, he heaved a sigh of relief and said, surely the bitterness of death is past. Surely, man, the bitterness is over. The threat of death is over. And then to his surprise or chagrin, the Bible said, Samuel took a sword and hacked him to pieces. And as he was hacking him to pieces, he said, as your sword has made mothers childless, and as your sword has made many widows without husbands, that means your sword has hacked a lot of people to pieces. You have made mothers who went to the birthplace, the labor ward. You have made them childless. You have made women childless, and you have made women widows without husbands. That means you have forced and cut off their lives. And as he was hacking him to pieces with the sword, he was reminding Ahab of what he had done previously. We're coming to elections, and sometimes violence, people believe that violence must be democratized. Violence is not part of our democracy. And so it must never be democratized. But what happens is that there are some people who pick up swords, cudgels, mattocks, you know, and weapons of mass destruction and weapons of warfare to inflict violence upon people, to violently attack people. And as for them, this is how they get their living. They get their living from drawing blood. They get their living from raising guns. They get their living from engaging in political violence. Look at what someone said to Ahab. Your sword has made a lot of women childless, and your sword has made a lot of women widows. So you, your mother also will suffer, and your wives too would also suffer. That's what he was saying. So you see, those who live by the sword, they die by the sword. If anybody advises you to pick up the sword of violence or to lift up the flag of violence and visit violence upon people, if you do that, I came to tell you that you have an expiry date, and it is the expiry date is going to be sooner than you think. The same violence will visit you, and with us, what you have made, if you maim others, if you kill others, if you sacrifice other people's lives, yours too will be done. How you make other women childless, you would also, your mother would also become childless. How you've made widows out of women, you would also be made a widow by virtue of the fact that you lifted the sword. Listen, let's eschew violence. We are one nation, one people, one destiny. We came just to make a choice. It should not go into violence, and nobody must pick up a sword to make somebody a widow, and to make somebody, not just a widow, to make another person childless. Do unto others as you would like others to do unto you. So what you do, be mindful, because with time, you pay a price. You know what? It's no good to lift up sword against your fellow man. Well, everybody has a choice. I have made a choice. See you later.